Hello, everybody. This is John, and you're listening to Purgatory News. And I got some good information for you tonight. What I wanted to talk to you about was what is going on in this country. And it's something that I find very disturbing. And that is suicide is going through the roof. And that crime is going through the roof. $18 Big Macs in Connecticut. I'm not kidding you. $18 for fast food, a Big Mac, because of inflation and the cost of living. Connecticut's very expensive, yes. But this is what's happening. It's almost cheaper to go grocery shopping and get the expensive food. I mean, it's out of control. I went in to Denny's. I don't like to eat the food, but I went in with a friend and got some food at Denny's. Now, I don't normally eat food like this because I try to stay away from all the processed food and stuff. Denny's is good, and I'm not knocking anybody who works there or eats there. But what I'm saying is we went in and I got a vegetable omelet and some hash browns. And my friend got, they said there was only two bacons, two sausage links, and three scrambled eggs. Without any taxes or tip, $29. And with taxes, it was $33. With the tip, it was $38. I just went in there to take the takeout. $38 for the food at Denny's in Texas. And the $18 that it cost for this Big Mac in the sandwich, I'll leave it below so you can all see it. This is what's going on in the country. We have families breaking up because their finances are out of line. What you have going on are people can't afford to keep up with the rising cost of living. People cannot afford to continue down this path. Inflation is going to continue to go up. Lo and behold, Janet Yellen and Jerome Powell have basically said, well, we had over $1 trillion that we had to borrow from March to September. So maybe from October to January, we're only gonna have to borrow $778 billion, which would give us a budget deficit of $1.7 trillion. So the markets were up 500 plus points today because of that. So they're basically trying to tell you, oh, don't worry about it. It'll be all right because we have a $1.7 trillion deficit that we've broken up from a trillion, and we broke it up into $778 billion that we're going to have to borrow that they think by the end of the year. But with inflation, you have rates that are going to continue to go up more than likely. But they're saying, maybe we won't have to raise them because the Fed has already said we've lost the battle with inflation. There's no way of stopping it. We've lost. And so what that simply means to an average person like you or me, it means that the cost of food, the cost of the pump, the value of your currency, and the value of the money that you go and work two jobs, three jobs, or worked hard for a career, or you're an entrepreneur like me, it means that the value of those items are going to continue to go down as de-dollarization continues to accelerate. Our enemies know we're weak and that we've taken advantage of them with their resources and our endless wars. People, we have to stand up for one another. We have to fight for each other. We have to know that we've been used by our feckless leaders who have imprisoned Americans, who have use the best of us against each other with all of these civil wars, all of these wars that are in this country right now. All the wars that we're fighting amongst ourselves, all the anti-Semitism that's going on in the United States and around the West, and the rest of the world. We need to stop it. We need to come together. They're taking us to World War III. They are. It's happened. And it's only a matter of time before this gets worse. So the question becomes, what are you going to do about it? Are you going to be prepared? Are you going to be scared? Because if you're not prepared, you should be scared. If you are prepared, then you should be aware. And if you are aware, then you should be asking yourself who's watching the watchers. So what we have to do is we have to be fiscally sound in our life. I encourage you to become an entrepreneur. I encourage you to read. I encourage you to help one another. And I encourage you to get into commodities and precious metals. I encourage you to prep, buy extra food and water. I watch all of these channels like Appalachian Homestead, A Prepper Princess, excuse me, Dan from iAllegedly, Economic Ninja, Johnny Bravo, Canadian Prepper. I have a few more that I could tell you, but subscribe to these channels because they bring a lot of value. They really do. I can also tell you that everything that's going on in this world is going to continue to get worse, but we can make it better by helping each other and understanding that you need to own a gun, you need to learn self-defense, and you need to learn how to be self-sufficient by learning new skills, reading the labels on the food that's garbage, growing our own food so that we are self-sufficient, a self-sufficient people. Times are getting tougher, guys. The holidays are coming. So you need to stand up for one another. You need to fight for one another. And you need to take care of one another. Because what's important right now is that you understand that they want to kill you. The police aren't coming to save you when this happens. And the only people that can stand a chance is by you helping each other, forming our own communities, forming our resistance and our self-sufficiency and reliance. Because the more we do that, the more that we become our own banks, the more that we can be self-sufficient, and the more that we can get back to the simple things in life like family, God, friends, self-sufficiency, and wealth. Because when you're wealthy, you have options. You can buy your time back and do more things. Take chances you've never thought you could do. Become more than you really truly could be. Your family needs you. And if you're listening to this right now, and you don't think you're worth it, you are worth it. You are worth it. You're a human being, and you have a 1 in 18 trillion chance of being in this world. You are worth it, no matter what anybody said, you're worth it. And if you ever need anything, please reach out to me. I will be glad to talk with you. I want to know what's going on in all of your lives. So please, write, like, subscribe, comment. It helps get my name out there. It helps get the algorithms to boost my presence on the YouTube channel. Guys, take care of one another. And remember, be prepared and not scared. Purgatory News, out.